what do you mean by ISO? And when was this formed, Anoo?
It dates back to around Second World War.
Oh, is it
so? You wouldn't believe me, I know,
okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what the UN came together, mm-hmm. they formed an ISO,
mm-hmm.
and they wanted everything to be standardized and the system to be in place for any organization we do.
So this is the history of ISO?
Yes.
Great.
Exactly.
Awesome. And how long your organization is doing this service?
For around 15 years now.
Oh, great.
Yes.
More than a decade.
Yes.
Okay. So where all you are located? Okay.
Exactly.
So basically, like, I just want to understand an organization with ISO and without ISO, what will be the difference? I would love to know that this ISO got so many standards, if I'm right.
Yes.
So maybe can you give some briefing about it?
See, when I attended the program, my trainer told me that I had this flair for auditing and for consulting.
Oh, great.
And
okay.
So I thought, okay, why not give it a chance? That's how it all started.
I would love to know, because now India is more focused on IT industry.
True.
So in any way, this ISO is going to help IT industries. If so, what is the standard you help with them?
Definitely.
Okay.
We
maybe
have
you
PBS.
Can specify on segment-wise so that we can understand these are all the same.
We are pioneers in automobile industry.
Okay. Okay.
Which was how I got to know about this money,
okay,
you
okay.
know, the whole thing.
Okay.
Yeah. So we are looking at a training parallel currently.
Okay.
So we think we'll step into the training, like how we have
great.
A name for automobile industry, we'll have a name for training as well.
Also. Very
yeah,
good.
That's
you are right. Absolutely. It's not only just setting up the standard. Training only makes the person
exactly.
to implement it.
Exactly.
So it plays a vital role.
Correct.
Yeah.
Because a lot of
fantastic.
Walk in.
And how big is your team,
We are a team of 50 people.
50.
Out of which.
Previous, what is maybe one best success story? Which you would love to share here.
Okay. So we are not allowed to disclose the name of a few
organization,
clients.
Okay, but
however, I will tell you after developing this rapport, I think you
great.
Deserve to know.
Okay, okay,
more.
Great. I want to know what is the secret of your training made him to wear his gloves.
I would invite you to come and attend
sure,
one
sure,
of
definitely.
The trainings.
Friends, welcome to RS Money's Your Business Talk Show. Welcome, Anoo.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Fantastic.
Good.
Okay, welcome to the show. It was our pleasure to have you in the studio.
Pleasure is mine as well.
Great. And I would love to know what you do.
I'm a senior executive
okay.
in Beacon Desyne Management Consultant Private Limited.
Okay.
So we are a consulting firm basically.
Mm-hmm.
We started this off around 15 years ago.
Okay.
And we have been into consulting.
Okay.
We are pioneers in training and
okay.
we also give away certifications for ISO standards.
Oh, great. Okay, awesome. And what do you mean by ISO?
It is International Organization for Standardization.
Okay.
In an international level, we have decided to standardize every organization that is ever in existence.
Okay.
So that is the prime requirement.
Great. And when was this formed, Anoo?
It dates back to around Second World War.
Oh, is it
you
so?
You wouldn't believe me, I know,
okay.
right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what actually happened was there were a lot of bombs that was deployed,
okay.
but many bombs did not burst.
Oh, I see.
So when they tried to analyze and find out the root cause, we found out that it was because none of the systems were maintained.
Mm-hmm.
So the UN came together,
mm-hmm.
they formed an ISO,
mm-hmm.
and they wanted everything to be standardized and the system to be in place for any organization.
Oh.
So that's exactly what we do.
So this is the history of ISO?
Yes.
Great.
Exactly.
Awesome. And how long your organization is doing this service?
For around 15 years now.
Oh, great.
Yes.
More than a decade.
Yes.
Okay. So where all you are located?
We have located in Virgambakkam
okay.
in Chennai.
Okay.
And we have other, you know, we have spread our wings to Pune.
Okay.
In Hyderabad.
Okay.
In Coimbatore, Madurai.
Okay. Okay.
And we are also looking at Bangalore for now.
Fantastic.
Yes.
Awesome. Okay. So let me understand more, like what does this ISO, in what way ISO helps business organization?
See, a lot of people out there, we see a lot of entrepreneurs
yes.
these days.
Yes.
They just start a firm because they want to do something and contribute to the society to make the world a better place.
Okay.
But down the lane somewhere they everything gets diluted.
Mm-hmm.
They really don't know how to maintain, how to run the firm anymore.
Mm-hmm.
So what, see, this is exactly where consultants like us come into place.
Mm-hmm.
We go to the organization,
mm-hmm.
we look at them, we mm-hmm. see what system is in place,
okay.
what are the requirements that ISO quotes for,
okay.
and we try to bridge the gap. We
okay.
give them solutions,
okay.
which we call as management solutions.
Okay.
And we also train the personnel out there
okay.
to interpret the standards
mm-hmm.
to a layman's understanding, of
okay.
course.
Okay.
And we also certify them. So
okay.
that's exactly how we help organizations. We provide management solutions
management
to them.
Solution. Okay.
Exactly.
So basically, like, I just want to understand an organization with ISO and without ISO, what will be the difference?
The basic we have this concept called 5S,
okay.
which is nothing but cleanliness.
Okay.
So that will be the first major difference.
Okay.
The second major difference would be mm-hmm. that you will have a system in place.
Mm-hmm.
Without system, the whole organization will be a haywire.
Mm-hmm.
You will have a lot of havoc happening.
Sure.
And the cost analysis, we call it the cost to quality.
Mm-hmm.
So that will not be there.
Mm-hmm.
Once we walk in and we optimize the system,
mm-hmm.
you will have the best quality ever.
Okay.
And the cost that is sort of invested
mm-hmm.
into all these management system
mm-hmm.
comes down to a drastic level, trust
okay.
me.
Yeah. Mm, great. Okay. So you feel that in the performance of the organization and even the profit of the organization will increase?
Yes, that's exactly what I said.
Okay.
Yeah.
So which all the categories or the areas you are giving the services?
ISO is basically a uniform platform.
Okay.
So any organization out there,
okay.
right from the manufacturer of cell phones,
okay.
to the clothing that we wear,
okay.
to these boards.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Anything under the sky can, like any organization for that matter, can go for an ISO certificate.
Okay.
We have audited firms that has ranged only from 30 by 30 square feet
uh-huh.
until big MNCs like TVS.
Oh, I see.
So
okay.
there are awesome. Clients.
Okay,
yeah.
great. And I would love to know that this ISO got so many standards, if I'm right.
Yes.
So maybe can you give some briefing about it?
See, personally, I feel that industrialization as such and urbanization has
mm-hmm.
made the world a sort of a place wherein people talk about pollution and all that.
Mm-hmm.
So there is this particular standard called Environment Management System,
mm-hmm.
EMS 14001:2015.
Mm-hmm.
So I would recommend that any organization out there,
mm-hmm.
please go ahead with this standard.
Mm-hmm.
It calls for a lot of legal and other requirements,
mm-hmm.
and it also gives us an opportunity to contribute to a better and a greener living out there.
Oh,
so
great.
Yes, that is one thing that I personally
and,
recommend.
Okay,
apart then, from that,
okay.
if you think you have to take good care of your employees
mm-hmm.
or you as employees, you think you need to take care of yourself because the work conditions are not safe enough or the work as such is not a very safe place. It
mm-hmm.
is affecting your health by any sort.
Mm-hmm.
We have OHSMS
mm-hmm.
which is 45001:2018 standard
mm-hmm.
and previously it was not an ISO standard
mm-hmm.
so we have upgraded it
okay.
now
okay.
so 45001:2018
mm-hmm.
OHSMS is a standard you can go for
okay.
Occupation Health Safety Management System
okay.
that's how we call it
okay.
so that is a good standard for you
okay.
know employees and for employers
okay.
as well
so it is
yeah.
not only improvising the business also it is a safety standard for the employees
exactly,
to
exactly.
make them happy and
yes it
safe.
Talks more about occupation health and their safety
okay.
in workplace
okay.
especially
okay
yeah.
great and how long you as the you are in the service
For more than 5 years now
oh great
yeah
okay.
and still counting
okay
yeah.
so like what is your background
I'm an engineer, a chemical engineer,
okay.
B.Tech in chemical engineering.
Okay.
So after that, I was into research for 1.5 years.
Okay.
And prior to that, I was working in an automobile industry as a quality manager.
Okay.
So after the 1 year of research, I took a break. And after that, I was also associated with a laboratory
mm-hmm.
as a quality manager deputy.
Mm-hmm.
So that's when we had a requirement to go for NABL standards.
Mm-hmm.
It was a requirement given by one of our customers.
Okay.
When I attended the program, my trainer told me that I had this flair for auditing and for consulting.
Oh, great.
And
okay.
So I thought, okay, why not give it a chance? That's how it all started.
Awesome.
And then whatever happened is... industry. Today I'm certified for about 8 to 9 different standards as a lead auditor.
So what all can you name it?
For aerospace standards, for automobile standards, for laboratory standards, for the general ISO QMS quality management system standard, and for environment management system, for occupation health safety assessment series, and the list keeps going, trust
basket
me.
Basket full of standards.
Yes.
Okay, great. Awesome.
But I'm looking at ship management now.
Oh, okay.
So, in the near future.
No, great. Awesome.
Yeah.
And I would love to know, because now India is more focused on IT industry.
True.
So, in any way, this ISO is going to help IT industries. If so, what is the standard you help with them?
Definitely. As I said before, I see a lot of IT people working all throughout the nights. You have a lot of health issues coming up because of that. Both men and women. Women especially, we have issues like PCOS. You have the L1 and L2 disc, whatever they talk about, gets affected,
right.
Because they sit in the same place for long hours of time, then their eyes get affected.
That's true.
And in fact, personally, I know a friend of mine who became a lunatic. Yes, she turned almost into a lunatic, and she's been under treatment for about a year or so.
Very bad,
already,
yeah.
Because she was into an IT you know, workspace. So,
okay, but do you think that this ISO, implying this ISO, will make them happy?
Definitely.
Or will not lead to this situation?
Especially a standard like 45001, OHSMS, I think definitely that will create a lot of you know, awareness among the general public out there.
Okay.
And they would know that no matter what, we all work for money and to, and we earn money to lead a better life.
That's true.
If you're putting your life at stake for all the money, I don't think all of this makes sense.
True.
Yeah.
Fine. And we would love to know that who all the major clients you have served.
We have Omnex. We have Hyundai.
Okay.
We
maybe
have
you
TBS.
Can specify on segment wise so that we can understand these are all the segments.
We are pioneers in automobile industry.
Okay.
So anything related to automobile, we are the one stop solution.
Awesome.
Out there.
Okay.
So that is the name that we have in the market.
Okay.
In
and love to know that you want to be pioneer in some specific segments also. You are focusing?
We are looking at automobile. See, apart from consulting, we have the technical guys.
Okay.
Our technical team, they are very sound at what they do. So they know the requirement and the interpretation of the requirement. So we are looking at a training parallel currently.
Okay.
So the materials are all under design right now.
Okay.
Which was how I got to know about this money.
Okay.
You know, the whole thing.
Okay.
Yeah. So we are looking at a training parallel currently.
Okay.
So we think we'll step into the training, like how we have a name for automobile industry, we'll have a name for training as well.
Training also. Very good.
That's
you're right, absolutely. It's not only just setting up the standard. Training only makes the person to implement it.
Exactly.
So it plays a vital role.
Correct.
Yeah.
Because a lot of firms, they think the standard is calling for something else, but it will be, you know, the requirement will be something else. So they should understand how to interpret standards. Which is exactly what we teach in the training sessions.
Okay, great.
Yes.
Awesome. Okay, fine. In person, I would love to know, like, what is your service, what you are offering to your organization?
Okay. I am a consultant.
Okay.
So any organization that would require a technical assistance, so I'm the person for that.
Okay.
I go to organizations, I visit them.
Okay.
We take a tour, organization tour.
Okay.
We check out what are all the places where there can be improvements made.
Okay.
We check for the gaps for the requirement and the current system. We try to bridge it. We put a particular set of procedures in place and also some documents that is required to be maintained in order to ensure that the procedures have been implemented as such.
Okay.
To call for the requirements.
Okay.
So that is one part of the job.
Okay.
The second part of the job is that given any requirement, there are a lot of customer audits that has been handled.
Okay.
So customer requirements are generally given to us.
Okay.
We represent the customers.
Okay.
We go to a particular organization, we audit.
Okay.
We also represent certification bodies. I am a registered auditor for RICL, Royal Impact Certification.
Okay.
So I represent that particular certification body.
Okay.
I go to organizations and I audit people for that particular standard.
Great, great. So you are more on the implementation.
Correct. That's
and
right.
Making sure that it is all being used. Yes. In organization intact.
Yes. But training is what I'm interested in.
Great.
So I'd say in a month, say around 3 to 4 trainings I handle.
Oh, you handle there. Okay. Yes. So it will be more purely on technical side?
Yes. Okay. Related to standards. And sometimes if required, there are few requirements, say for enable you have uncertainty of measurement.
Great.
So we have a particular set of standards for that.
Awesome.
So such trainings I handle.
Awesome.
It
awesome.
Lasts for about 4 to 5 days generally.
Okay.
If it's a lead auditor training, it's 5 days.
Okay.
So if it's an internal auditor training, it lasts for 2 days.
Great. Okay. Yeah. Who is the owner of your organization?
Our director is Mr. Vijay.
Okay.
So he's not here
okay.
today.
So how long he's in the service?
He's in service for around 25 to 30 years.
25 years of experience.
Yes, definitely. Definitely.
Oh, okay.
He's a great man.
Oh, great. Awesome. Yes. Okay. And one final question. What is your vision 2020? Your organization vision, what you are thinking about?
We are emphasizing more on environmental management system
mm-hmm.
because with all the Go Green and Bharat 4 and 5 coming up,
mm-hmm.
I think we would want to make the world a better place to live in
mm-hmm.
and to improvise life and make it easier and better.
Oh, great. Okay.
Yes.
Fantastic. Okay. So now I hope we have much understood you and now
hopefully.
Yeah, great. And I hope the audience also would have understood much about your organization.
Definitely.
And more definitely. About ISO also and more about you also.
Thank you.
Great. So I would love you to talk to the audience. Your ask.
Okay.
What you want to ask them and how they can get connected to you.
Okay. See, I think forget about all the organization, forget about all this. Look at yourself as an individual. As an individual, what is it that you're trying to contribute to the society? How are you trying to make your own place a better place to be? If there's any small thing that you can do, like planting a sapling or reducing waste or utilizing water in a better way, I think you should go ahead and do it. If you need some solutions based on that or related to that, you can anyway contact us on beacondesyne.org.
Great. Awesome. Yeah. And any contact number you can share them?
9841545460.
Awesome. Yeah. Anoradha, having here in the studio, it was
Thank
our
you.
Pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you very
much.
Mine
as well. Sure. Thank you.